Russia successfully test launched its Zircon, also known as Tsirkon, hypersonic cruise missile from the Project 22350 Admiral Gorshkov warship. The test took place on the 19th of July, 2021. Viewers may note that the warship has 16 UKSK VLS cells, each of which can accommodate a single Zircon missile. The Russian Defense Ministry, in a statement, said that the missile was fired from the Admiral Gorshkov frigate in the White Sea. It was added that it struck a ground target located on the coast of the Barents Sea, more than 350 kilometers or 217 miles away, with the missile traveling at 7 times the speed of sound. The ministry said that the tactical and technical characteristics of the Tsirkon missile were confirmed during the tests. Russian President Vladimir Putin has stated that Tsirkon was part of a new generation of missile systems without equal in the world. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the Russian Tsirkon hypersonic missile is actually lethal. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. In 2018, Putin announced that Russia was developing a series of new weapons. Tsirkon was one of them. The missile represents a further development of the HELA, hypersonic experimental flying vehicle, developed by NPO Mashina Stroyenia, that was on display at the 1995 MAX air show. As per President Putin's address in the Russian Federal Assembly, the Tsirkon is capable of reaching speeds of Mach 9. President Putin mentioned that the missile is able to destroy both seagoing and land targets. As per reports, the Tsirkon will have both a radar target seeker and an optical electronic complex to detect and track targets. The missile could be equipped with a high explosive warhead or even a tactical nuclear warhead. Mr. Putin had told the Tsirkon is mainly intended to be deployed in seagoing platforms, such as serially made surface warships and submarines, including those that are already operational and being built. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed the speeds of Mach 5, or 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. While there are several ways to achieve hypersonic speed, Tsirkon is thought to use a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engines can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missiles to reach hypersonic speeds. These engines have no moving parts, like the compressors and turbines used in turbofan engines found on conventional jet planes. They rely on the huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. In this method, a rocket booster is used to accelerate the missile to hypersonic speed. Then the scramjet engine kicks in and enables the missile to fly at a sustained hypersonic speed. It must be noted that traditional ballistic missiles like American Minuteman III, Russian Sarmat, or Indian Agni missiles all travel at hypersonic speeds, but they follow a predictable ballistic trajectory and can't maneuver mid-course. This is where a hypersonic missile is different, since they have very high speed but can also maneuver in flight. There are four aspects that make Zircon a lethal weapon. 1. The speed makes it almost unstoppable. It's noted that even the excellent Aegis system equipping the American Arleigh Burke-class destroyers will be too slow to react in time. 2. Since Zircon is heavy and fast, it will have lots of kinetic energy, which will come into play along with the explosive warhead, and a single hit from it could be enough to cripple even a supercarrier. 3. Another important aspect of the missile is its plasma cloud. As per multiple reports, the air pressure in front of the weapon forms a plasma cloud as it moves and completely covered by plasma cloud during the flight. The plasma cloud would absorb radio frequencies emitted from radars, and since the waves are not reflected back, it will essentially mean that the missile will be partially invisible. It's highly likely that the missile will be detected very late, and this will make intercepting Zircon almost impossible with the current crop of air defense systems. 4. The missile can actually fly at low altitude, and hence it's very hard to defend against, as the radar will catch it much later when compared to traditional missiles. Zircon's characteristics would give air defenses very little time to detect and fire interceptors. Current air defense systems can defend against subsonic missiles reliably and are effective against supersonic missiles to an extent, but against hypersonic missiles, they'll fail. It's to be noted that America's Government Accountability Office, GAO, report has stated that the U.S. currently lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range, conventional, and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. In its response to the GAO, the Department of Defense described the report as an accurate, although sobering, macro picture of how the U.S. stands in the world against emerging threats.